Hello and welcome to TranslatorsCafe.com channel. In this video, we'll talk about energy. We'll discuss units for measuring energy, different properties of energy, and ways of its generation, including green energy. Finally, we'll discuss some other interesting facts about energy. Energy is a notion central to physics, chemistry, physiology, and life itself. Neither life nor motion is possible without energy. In physics, it is defined as a property of objects or fields which allows it to perform work on other objects, for example, to cause motion. The SI unit for energy is a joule. 1 joule represents the amount of energy expended while applying a force of 1 newton to a body and moving it for 1 meter. The kinetic energy of a moving object is the energy which this object possesses as a result of its motion. A moving body maintains its kinetic energy until its speed changes. Kinetic energy of an object that is not moving is zero. Potential energy, on the other hand, is the energy of a body at rest. It is the energy needed to keep the body in the current position in space. For example, before a football is hit by the player, the forces acting upon it, like gravity and the resistance of the Earth, make it stay still in that position. At that moment, its potential and kinetic energy is zero. Once it bounces off after the kick and is moving away, it has both kinetic and potential energy. As it moves, kinetic energy converts to the potential energy, or vice versa. Let us look at an example of such energy conversion. When a stone is thrown directly up, it flies and slows down. As it slows down, its kinetic energy is converted to potential energy. Eventually, the potential energy peaks when the stone stops flying up. The stone then falls down, and as it accelerates, kinetic energy increases, while the potential energy decreases. Eventually, at the moment of impact with the Earth, right before the stone stops moving, its kinetic energy reaches maximum. The law of energy conservation states that the total amount of energy in an isolated system stays constant. Throughout the fall of the stone in the example above, its potential and kinetic energy is changing. But the sum of the two is constant, because kinetic energy converts to potential energy and vice versa. Potential and kinetic energy can be used to perform work, such as putting objects in motion. Humans have used this principle to accomplish numerous difficult tasks with the help of various devices and machines. For example, kinetic energy of moving water was used for many centuries to move water mills that produce flour. As more and more people use technology in everyday life, for example, cars and computers, the demand for energy is constantly increasing. Currently, the primary sources of energy are non-renewable. This means that they are fuels mined from the Earth, and their source is not being replaced at a speed fast enough to meet the oncoming demand. Examples of such fuels are coal, oil, and uranium. The latter is used to produce nuclear energy. In recent years, renewable energy, or energy from sources that can be renewed by human technology, is on the agenda of most governments and many international organizations, such as the UN. A large number of research projects is focused on finding renewable energy that can be generated with a minimal cost. Some of the currently used renewable energy technologies generate wind, solar, and wave energy. Energy generated for industrial and home use is generally converted into electric energy. Electric power is generated by batteries or electric generators. The first power plants generated electricity from coal and hydroelectric power, but eventually other sources appeared, such as petroleum, natural gas, solar, and wind energy sources. The main principle behind power generation is to convert energy to the kind that is easy to transport and to use, mostly electricity. Occasionally, large industrial facilities generate their own energy, but more commonly, energy production is done in power stations on the industrial scale. Power stations are more convenient, and it is not logistically or economically feasible to produce energy in every household. This is especially true for generation of power that heavily relies on expensive technology or technology that requires constant monitoring and safety measures. Some examples of such technologies include those used in nuclear, wave, or wind power generation. One of the reasons that electric energy was chosen as the primary energy source for households and the industry is that it is easy to transport over long distances using power lines and the losses are minimal. Electricity can be generated from mechanical, thermal, and other forms of energy. Examples of mechanical energy include energy generated by turbines that are moved by water, steam, or gas, or air. Steam is created by burning fossil fuels or from nuclear reactions. As we discussed earlier, fossil fuels are non-renewable fuels excavated from the earth and include petroleum, natural gas, or coal. Renewable sources of energy include biomass as well as solar, ocean, and thermal energy. In some areas, the power supply infrastructure is lacking due to economic and logistic constraints. If the power supply is not constant or it is not possible to access the grid, then backup or portable systems are used. Many individuals, businesses, and organizations, for example hospitals, use small generators to produce electricity. These are usually reciprocating engines which burn fossil fuels and convert the energy generated in this process into mechanical motion. Fossil fuels have formed over millions of years from the remains of plants and animals under conditions of extreme pressure and heat within the Earth's crust. They are usually high in carbon. These fuels release energy when burned, but they also release carbon dioxide, one of the greenhouse gases. At the moment, fossil fuels are the major source of energy for power generation across the globe. When burned, these fuels release greenhouse gas emissions. The emissions, in turn, contribute to global warming. An additional problem with fossil fuels is that they are not renewable and are being depleted faster than the new fossil fuels are being created. If we rely on fossil fuels, one day we will run out of energy sources. Nuclear energy is one alternative to fossil fuels. It is generated through a controlled nuclear fission reaction, where a nucleus of an atom splits into smaller parts and releases energy. The energy heats water and produces steam. The steam moves the turbines. Nuclear energy poses safety concerns. Some of the most notable and infamous nuclear power plant accidents include the Chernobyl disaster in Ukraine, the Three Mile Island accident in the USA, and the Fukushima disaster in Japan. After the Fukushima disaster, several countries started the process of re-evaluating their use of nuclear power. Some countries, such as Germany, are now working on closing down their nuclear power plants in the near future. An additional problem is the storage of spent nuclear fuel. Fuel is needed for the fission reaction to occur, and it can be reused, but eventually it has to be replaced. Some of the byproducts of nuclear power production can be reused in other industries, such as medicine or weapon production, but most of the material has to be stored as radioactive waste. Currently, each country has their own storage systems for the spent fuel. They include repositories in geological structures or the ocean floor, as well as storage in pools or casks for spent fuel. This poses problems and risks such as high cost, leakage, running out of storage, and hostile attacks on the storage facilities. Other alternatives include using renewable power sources, such as energy from waves, sunlight, and wind. At the moment, these alternative sources are not developed enough to replace fossil fuels. However, they are becoming more and more popular thanks to the subsidies provided by some governments and also because these energy sources are much less harmful to the environment than the non-renewable ones. Solar energy experiments started in the 19th century, but this technology was not widely used until recently. In recent years, solar industry is developing very rapidly due to demand and subsidies from governments and international organizations. Solar farms, which are large areas covered with solar panels, were first built in the 1980s. Most often solar energy is collected and electricity is generated by means of photovoltaic panels. Sometimes heat engines are used in which solar energy heats water and resulting water vapor rotates the turbines, which in turn rotate generators. Wind energy has been used by humans for a long time. The first major use was in sailing, as far as 7,000 years ago. Windmills have also been in use for hundreds of years. The first wind turbines were created in the 1970s. Tidal energy has also been used since the time of the Roman Empire, but the energy of waves and currents has only been used recently. In recent years, stations that harvest wave, tidal, and current energy are being built and tested. While the idea of generating energy from marine power is not new, devices that harvest this energy on a large scale need to be further developed and tested. This is mainly due to high cost of building such power stations and to the lack of advancement in current technologies. Biomass or biofuel generates energy when plant material is burned. During this process, solar energy that plants generated through photosynthesis is released as heat. It is widely used in everyday life, for example, to provide warmth for heating and cooking and also as fuel for transportation. Alcohols and oils can be made from plants. Animal fat-based biofuel is also in use. One variation of biofuel, biodiesel, is used in the automotive industry both as an additive to other diesel fuels or by itself. The Earth stores energy in its core in the form of heat. Earth's crust has been hot since its original formation, and additional heat is constantly generated from radioactive decay of minerals. Until recently, this energy has been accessible mostly in the areas that lie around the borders of tectonic plates, where hot springs are present. Now, geothermal wells are created to have access to this energy more widely. This is a costly process, however. Hydroelectric energy is another alternative to fossil fuels. Hydro-generated power is considered by many to be clean energy with little negative environmental impact. Indeed, greenhouse gas emissions are not a problem for hydroelectric energy as they are for fossil fuels. Hydroelectric energy is generated by water flow. This type of energy has been in use by humans for a long time. A water mill is one example of using it. Electricity is currently generated at hydroelectric stations by harvesting kinetic energy of flowing water of rivers or potential energy of water in dams. this energy moves water turbines. The dams use the height difference between the reservoir from which the water flows and the river into which the water flows. Despite the positive aspects of hydroelectric energy, numerous problems exist with its generation. For example, displacing and damaging habitats when building dams causes considerable harm to the biodiversity. As a result of building dams, plants and animals become cut off from the resources normally available in their ecosystem. For example, fish may not be able to go upstream to lay eggs. Some species may be unable to adjust to a new environment. Energy in nutrition and exercise is usually measured in kilojoules or food calories. One food calorie is formally defined as the amount of energy needed to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water by 1 degree in the Kelvin scale. One food calorie is equivalent to 1 kilocalorie or 1000 calories in the scientific notation. This is about 4.2 kilojoules. When we talk about food calories, the word food is often omitted, so they are called simply calories. There are 9 calories per gram in fats, 4 calories per gram in carbohydrates and proteins, and 7 calories per gram in alcohols. Some other substances also contain calories. This energy stored in food is released and made available to the living organism during metabolism. The word energy is widely used in marketing products. For example, energy drinks are sold as performance-enhancing beverages. They generally contain stimulants like caffeine, sometimes herb extracts, and plenty of sugar. Stimulants increase blood flow, heart rate, blood pressure, and temperature and produce a feeling of high, of being energized and capable. This happens because the increase in blood flow brings more oxygen to the brain. Energy drinks should not be consumed while exercising because they negatively affect the electrolyte balance in the body. They often contain very high levels of stimulants and provide a brief boost period followed by a withdrawal period. Energy drinks may also have other side effects, such as nausea and vomiting, headaches, high blood pressure, irregular heart rate, and insomnia. It is better not to drink energy drink at all. Your natural energy is enough for you. If you feel tired, just have a good rest. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel.